channel yet again. So as some of you probably know, I'm in college.
Weird, right?
And I found that college makes it extremely difficult to find time to go to the gym. It seems like I always have a never-ending list of things to do. I mean, there's work, class, Netflix, sleeping, hanging out with friends. Did I say there's Netflix? Give this video a thumbs up if you feel me on that. However, lately I've tried to make it a priority to be active for at least 30 minutes a day, and honestly I've found that it makes me happier, it makes me feel better, and it makes me healthier. So, without further ado, let's get into it! So, I start off right away putting my hair in a ponytail because who wants sweaty hair in their face? No one! Then, of course, I grab my phone and I go to my Spotify workout playlist, super essential to working out. So for abs, I like to start out doing planks. I usually start with a front plank for 1 minute and then 1 minute on each of the two sides and then back to the front for another minute. To increase difficulty, lift your legs up and down when you're in your side plank. Run the same course. Then I usually do 50 reach arounds, and you have to make sure that you're touching your hand to your ankle because that's what makes it the hardest. I don't know what to call this one, but it targets your inner thighs, which is usually a problem for me and something I like to work on. You can either lift your leg up and down, or you can draw circles with your feet both ways, or write out the alphabet. Then I usually do about 50 flutter kicks. They're really good for your legs and your abs. I don't really know what this is, but medicine balls are really good because it adds weight to your arms and makes it a full body workout. When targeting the booty, there are so many different workouts you can do, and these are just some of my favorites. They're pretty easy. When you're squatting, make sure to keep your body aligned. Don't lean over or hunch over. Do 15 back kicks on each leg if you want to tone your butt and the back of your thighs. Or you can do the classic fire hydrant. I like to do both, even though they look kind of stupid. I don't do much for my arms because I don't want to get them buff. I just want to keep them toned. I usually do about 10 bicep curls on each arm. When I can't run on a treadmill or run outside, I like to use a bike. It's less harsh on your knees, but it still gets your heart rate going and you sweat a lot. Alright you guys, so that's it for my fitness routine of 2015. That rhymed. I'm a poet and I didn't even know it. Shout out to my friend Monica Church for helping me film this video and for also showing me that it's not that hard to work out for a short amount of time. There are actually ways to do it. So watching Netflix isn't a workout. Let me know in the comments below whether you would rather watch Netflix or go work out. I think we know the answer to that one. And again, if you think I'm a pretty cool human, you should be sure to subscribe to my channel for more weekly videos. And also subscribe to my collab channel called Just Like That, where I will also be posting weekly videos every single Monday. Alright, well, I love you guys so much, and I will see you next week. Bye!